I'm Betty. Rick and I want to welcome you to our Christmas table. I want to show you what we've made this year. I want to start here with the china because a lot of people mentioned the china in the Thanksgiving video and seem to be interested in it. Now this is just a fun set for Christmas this year, so I'm not using the fine china, but this is the kind you can buy at a nice department store. I can't say they're still in stock. This is Fitz & Floyd, and it's 1994. So I received it as a gift about 20 years ago. And we have our napkin in Christmassy colors, and then our knife, a soup spoon, and a spoon, and over here our fork and salad fork. And then I try to do a butter pat like this one, just an amount of butter for a roll. And then a small salt and pepper for the individual. And I don't have my glass filled with tea, but I will show you. I have two pitchers of tea like this. I always serve iced tea with a holiday meal. So we'll put this back and it will get filled. I have fresh hot coffee right here. And instead of having ice water, you might notice I have something over here. This is orange wassail, and I'll talk about that in a minute because it is on the table. Here I have the butter for the entire table, and this is an antique glass butter dish. And I have my friends that are teddy bears that I like to put in a lot of Christmassy things. And here we have our sugar and creamer, and this has milk actually because I don't really like to use cream that much. I have placed two rolls in this bread dish, or I'm treating this as a bread dish right in this instance, because this is not a huge place setting. It doesn't have all of the things that the antique china has. So I use this for a bread plate as well as a dessert dish and things of that nature. The rolls that I made are called beer rolls. They're very easy. They have only three ingredients in them. You can't mess them up unless you burn them, but they're very tasty. And I want to tell you at the beginning of this table that I try to choose things for my holiday tables that are reasonable in terms of being easy to make and make the whole thing. And you can make them in order and sometimes freeze things or refrigerate if it's close to the date. Or in some cases, make on the very day of the dinner. Next, I have my appetizer, which is a cheese ball. Now, this is cranberry feta cheese ball. With that, I've decided to use ginger snaps and sliced apples. These are red delicious apples. When you put them on a plate like this, sprinkle them with a little lemon juice or lime juice to keep them nice and fresh looking. Want to show you what the ball looks like. It's white inside with a tinge of pink because it does have some red currant jelly, but the outside is composed of dried cranberries that have been chopped. Next, I have my healthy food, which is four bean salad. I've made three bean salad in Betty's kitchen, so this is quite similar. I just changed the beans somewhat and added another bean. This has been marinating all night in a mixture of white vinegar and olive oil, extra light tasting olive oil and sugar. So it really picks up those flavors and it's a delicious way to get some vegetables. Next we have sweet potato balls. Now if I cut into one of these, I did make them yesterday and I just heated them up so that they would be nice and warm. But you'll see the inside has the sweet potato. It's actually mixed with orange juice and sugar, and then it's rolled in pecans. So it's just delightful in terms of how it tastes, and it really goes great with a holiday meal. So Thanksgiving is past, but maybe next year. You might want it for Thanksgiving, or you might choose it for Christmas this year. Now, the last thing that came to the table was this, because it just finished being in the oven about 5 minutes ago, and we finished up that video. These are scalloped potatoes. I call them festive scalloped potatoes because they make a lot. So you might want to choose a time when you are going to have a lot of guests over. And also, they seem festive. So a holiday meal is just perfect. You can see the texture of them. They should be a little bit runny, but not too much. If they're too runny, then keep them in the oven a little bit longer, even if you have to lower the heat. But those are going to be delicious. Our entree for this meal is baked ham. So you can see this Kentucky Legend baked ham, which was pre-cooked. But what I did was to make a glaze, which you might be able to see the residue of. It had apricot jam or preserves, or in my case it was spreadable fruit, mixed with whole grain mustard and some brown sugar. Now that sat in the refrigerator overnight to get those flavors imbued in it, and then we baked it for about an hour and 15 minutes. It just needs to be heated up because it's pre-cooked. In the bottom of the roasting pan, there is this much glaze that's left, and of course some of the ham juices that have come out. So you can put that on the table and people can serve themselves, or you could actually, at this point before you serve it, glaze a little bit extra, and that will look nice. And I've decorated my platter with a couple of sprigs of rosemary. We're still getting some herbs in our garden, even though we've had a hard freeze in the last couple of weeks. Now, I mentioned earlier that we have orange wassail. It's a large recipe of it. There's a little bit more than this still available. Not much, but you want to serve this lukewarm, particularly if you're using antique glasses like I have here. This is actually a punch bowl, but the glasses that went with it have long gone and been broken, and I just happen to have these little dessert glasses that I chose to use, but I didn't want them to break, so lukewarm will be fine on that. It can also be served right from the refrigerator, chilled, if you like that. Next, we have our easy holiday truffles. And these are just so easy to make, and they're not going to fail on you. You have to wait a little while for them to set up, but that's the only disadvantage that they have. Those nuts inside are English walnuts. Now we come to more desserts. Here I have two pies. The recipe itself is designed to make two pies, so if you have a holiday dinner that you have to make a lot of food for, then it's a great recipe. And you can buy the pie crust pre-made, although I made these personally and baked them before we started this recipe. This is called crumb pie. And you might think, well, that's because of the top crumbs. Partly it is, but the actual inside of the pie is made with crumbs, and then it has molasses and some flavorings, and it makes a really great pie filling. It's a little cakey, but you can decorate it up with whipped topping and a mint leaf. Again, we're still having mints. I'm sorry I'm bragging about that, but I'm just amazed that we still have it in Kentucky at this time of year. And then we come to the largest amount of effort that went into any part of this table. This is a Kentucky blackberry jam cake. And I've got a piece right here, a huge piece. I'm sure that's many calories, although when you consider what's inside this cake, it's not decadent. It's just a good cake that has a good filling, that has blackberry jam in it, along with other things, nuts and so on. And the frosting is a caramel frosting, which is traditionally served with this type of cake. This is well known in Kentucky and is quite often served at Christmas time. So that's our blackberry jam cake. And I'll show you, if you cut into this, it kind of reminds you of fruit cake that isn't just packed with fruit, but it has a nice texture and a wonderful taste. And that brings us back to the head of the table. Rick and I want to wish you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.